All right. Let's talk for a minute about mineral spirits containers. They're kind of expensive, and you got a few options, so I'll tell you about what I use and why I like them. Probably the most basic here is the metal with two clasps on it. I use this jar for, I hook it onto my plein air backpack. And I like the size of this. You really don't need too much mineral spirits, especially when you're out painting plein air. But this is plenty big for me, I think. The way these are made, they're, you know, some type of a metal, and they've got a rubber ring, O-ring of some sort. I can't get this one out. But that creates the seal so that you don't have leaks. Now, they do tend to leak sometimes. And I also notice on these that this ring, this little rubber gasket here will shrink a little bit from time to time. Depends, you know, it seems like if I'm at a higher altitude, it's even worse. Here we go. So what I'll do if that's, when that happens, is I'll just gently stretch it out a little bit and pop it back in. You want it to seat down in the groove or you're not going to get a good fit. So this is what I take most of the time. It's really rugged. The second kind I'll start with this one. This is an Nalgene bottle. I got this from theprolificpainter.com. Nalgene is the brand, but Prolific Painter kind of puts the handle on here and a little brush scrubbing screen in the bottom. You know, this is lightweight. It's inexpensive. The Nalgene product here has no gasket, but the way it's built, it doesn't leak. And I've had good luck with these. There's many brands of jars that say they're not going to leak, but they eventually do, some sooner than later. The little metal screen in there lets you scrub your brush to remove the paint. A little agitator, I guess. And like I said, these are basic, very inexpensive, you know, and functional. They work, and it's light. So I like those. It's a good option. Here's the one I've been using. I actually take this on my plein air pack also. You can see it's kind of bent the handle. I've got some dirty mineral spirits in there now. But I've been painting with this one, you know, a dozen times or more, and no leak, which is great. The last one here is basically another metal one. It's actually got three clasps on there, a little bit better. I use this one only in the studio. And it gives me a little bit larger reservoir for the mineral spirits. And if I pull this out, this is the cup that sits down in there and allows you to kind of agitate the bristles again to get the pigment out. The pigment falls through the holes in the bottom of this cup, and then that pigment settles to the bottom here. So it holds more, it's a little bit bigger. The flared out base makes it a little more stable. That's why I like it in my studio. And the lid has the gasket in it again, so it doesn't leak. Now, when you go shopping for these, there is a wide price range here. Some of these are really expensive. If you buy like a Holbein, you can probably pay upwards of $50, maybe even up close to $100. But I haven't done that. I just, you know, you can see they get dirty, they get banged around. I don't see the need to spend that kind of money. They're probably made a little bit better, but you can find these at local stores like, your local art supply stores or online, and pay, $35 or less for them, much less on these plastic Nalgene. Now, one last tip, if you're going to take these out on your backpack, I guess two tips. So the first thing is, when I plein air paint, I do not put this in my pack. I've had lots of friends hiking around, and invariably in the pack, one of these comes loose, and it starts to leak everywhere. Well, by the time they start to paint, there's no mineral spirits left because it's spread all through their pack. So keep it on the outside of your pack, and I use a carabiner here. This is by Night Eyes, one of my favorite products, and a little secret tip for plein air painting. These carabiners have a slide lock here that will prevent it from opening. If you slide it up, then of course you can open it. So what I do is I will clip this onto the outside of my backpack, and then slide the locks in place so the carabiner will not open up. And then that just dangles from the back of my pack. Sometimes it can be noisy clanging around, but I've never had it open up, and I've never lost one of these. Now, before I put this sliding lock on, I had a regular carabiner, and I actually hiked in quite some ways in the backcountry to paint, and had to do some bushwhacking to get there. By the time I set up to paint, my carabiner had opened up, and my Turps can was gone. So, really, I can do a painting in the field without Turps. That's not a big deal, but losing a $35 can kind of sucks. So the Night Eyes Locking S-Beaner, or carabiner, they call it an S-Beaner, is a great way to attach anything to your pack and to keep it secure without losing it. Happy painting!